I'm sure by now you've been told that you should avoid debt at all costs. There are entire YouTube channels dedicated just to helping people get out of debt, and that is true to a certain extent, because when you're drowning in debt, your life is pretty much over because you become a slave to your monthly payments, always paying down your debt but never paying it off. This is because interest can compound your debt, and compounding interest is one of the most powerful forces in the entire universe. So that means you always want compound interest to be on your side, not against you. But there is some good news. Debt is not always bad. That isn't a popular opinion because most of the debt you probably have experience with is bad debt. I guarantee at one point or another you've had credit card debt, auto loan debt, student loans, and medical bills. When you remember all those debts, you're probably thinking, it'll take me decades to pay all of that off. How on earth can debt be a good thing? In this video, I'm going to show you how millionaires use special kind of debt to become richer faster than everyone else. What millionaires do is use debt to make even more money than the cost of their debt. It might sound a bit confusing, because why would anyone with a lot of money use debt in the first place? If you have a lot of money, why would you ever need to borrow money and pay interest and take that kind of risk? Only poor people who don't have money need to borrow money in order to do what they want. That is actually not how the economy works. Debt is the most powerful tool you can use to become rich. That is, if you know how to use debt the right way, which I will teach you in this video. The rich use debt to make large amounts of money fast by refinancing real estate with debt. They're able to do this because real estate debt has all kinds of legal loopholes you can use to make money by borrowing money. This is basically how the rich get richer in real estate. Let's say you have worked so hard for years at your office job and saved $200,000. That's a lot of money. But let's be honest, in the real estate game, that's not very much. You can't even buy a decent house with just $200,000. Of course, you can get a mortgage of up to $800,000 since you have to make a 20% down payment. But we can take this process one step further. Let's say you find a property that costs just $500,000. It's in a good location, but it hasn't been fixed in years and clearly needs a lot of renovation. Seeing an opportunity, you head to a bank and get a mortgage and make a 20% down payment. You calculate it'll cost 20% of the house's value just to fix it, which would be another $100,000. You spend a few months of hard work fixing the house and go back to the bank to get a new mortgage. In real estate, this is called refinancing your mortgage. What happens now will change your mind about debt. When you got your first mortgage on that fixer-upper house, the value of that property was just $500,000 because it was in such a bad condition that no one wanted to live there. But since you have fixed all the problems with the house, there are people who want to rent it out from you. So the market value of that property rises because it's in good condition and generating cash flow from rental income. You get the value of your house appraised and it's now worth $700,000. This is good because you originally spent $500,000 to buy the house and another $100,000 on renovations to fix it. Let's see how far you come out ahead. You get a new mortgage, this time with a 20% down payment and a loan on 80% of the value of the property. And 80% loan on the value of your $700,000 house is $560,000. You still need to pay off the first mortgage you took from the bank, which is $400,000. You've now made a profit of $160,000 just from the difference in the two mortgages. Now, remember you did spend another $100,000 on renovations. So after all of your costs, you now have made $60,000 with the power of debt. And on top of the $60,000 you've created almost out of thin air, thanks to debt, you also have a solid fixed property that's paying you passive income every single month. On bigger, more expensive properties, this money you can earn through debt would be even larger. But it gets even better. Because of how tax laws generally work in the United States, you're not going to pay taxes on your mortgage, because that's considered debt, a negative impact to your net worth. Every payment you make on your new mortgage reduces the cost of your tax bill each year. Nearly all real estate investors do this. And as you can see, this is one clear example of how debt is actually a really good thing when used in the right way. This doesn't just work with real estate either. If you have a business, you can borrow money to expand it and multiply your returns. With debt, you can expand, and after you're finished growing, you now control a new larger business because you borrowed money to hire more workers and purchase more equipment, expanding operations. All you had to do was borrow some money for a little time and return it back later, leaving you with a much larger business than before. If you had that same company and did not use debt to expand, it would take years to save up enough money to pay for the new equipment and hires that you need in order to grow your business operations. Instead, with debt, you can borrow money to expand quickly, pay off the loan, and take over market share faster than competitors who were too scared to borrow money. I hope this video unlocked the secret of how the rich use debt and changed how you look at money and investing. If you want to get started investing the right way, I have a link down in the description for the investing app M1 Finance. When you sign up using that link, when you deposit $100, you get $30 as a sign-up bonus, which is a 30% gain just for starting investing. That's all for this video, and good luck investing!